Let me grab Michael in Virginia Beach on a wild card line for John Wolkowitz. Go ahead, Michael.
Thank you very much. John, how do you spell your last name?
It's W-U-K-O-V-I-T-S. John Wolkowitz. I have a website, johnwolkowitz.com. All the books are available at Amazon or Barnes & Noble, you know, any outlets like that.
Well, thank you for that. Here's my point of interest in this whole discussion tonight. During the first hour, Ian talked about the Nazis who came to the United States and worked on our space program. What he didn't point out is the fact that they came here on Vatican passports, all of which has been well documented on this program by people like Annie Jacobson, people like Jim Mars, people like Joseph P. Farrell. Now, you said that the requirements for becoming a chaplain were that a man would have to have 4 years of college, 3 years of seminary, and 2 years working as a Catholic priest. Well, that would be impossible for the more than half of this population of Protestants who have their own chaplain. They wouldn't work for 2 years as a local parish priest. In the case of Germany, you didn't know.
Hey, you know, I need a question in here, and let me just tell you why. Because you started with a false premise. Wernher von Braun was brought over. There was a whole list of people. I think you're confusing something, and I know what you're confusing. You're confusing the rat line with the rocket scientists that we brought into the United States. So you're talking about the priests who, in many cases, well-documented Italian priests that were providing passports and safe passage to certain Nazis to get them out of Germany toward the end of the war. That's not what happened with the rocket scientists. They did go into the field, and they were attempting to blend in. But we sent over, and this is very well documented, we sent over an entire group of people whose whole job it was to bring back the rocket scientists. So they weren't in the group that you're talking about. So I just want to make that very clear so you understand. I wasn't omitting anything because it's not true. So if they got them here on a Catholic passport or something, I don't know exactly. I've never heard that. All I know is the army wanted them, they went and got them, and they brought them back. That's not the same as the rat line, okay?
Well, like I said, you can refer to the other three authors that I mentioned, but...
No, I'm not going to. I'm not going to... But here's the question. So you have a question for John? Go ahead.
He said he didn't know whether there were chaplains in the German army. Well, in the spring of 2011, when Jim Mars was on this show, he confirmed in his book, The Rise of the Fourth Reich, he confirmed what I said when I called in, that Hitler made a war pact with the Vatican in which the Vatican agreed that Catholic seminarians would carry arms for the German army.
Okay. So again, I'm going to put you on hold here because you're giving out some false information. I love Jim Mars. I know that book well. This isn't that conversation. You're having a separate conversation, and I understand you want to take a little victory lap about something, which is fair, but it's not accurate. So that this isn't relevant to this case. So John didn't say what you said, that there were no chaplains in the German army. He said exactly the opposite when I asked him that earlier. So let's just punt on that and get back to Barry in South.